The concept of engineering has existed since ancient times, as humans devised fundamental inventions such as the wheel, for example, the pyramids in ancient Egypt, the Acropolis and Parthenon in ancient Greece, the aqueducts used to transport water in and around Rome in the 4th century BC. One early example of what we nowadays call engineering. The Colosseum in the Roman Empire, the cities of the Mayan, Inca, and Aztec empires, the Great Wall of China, are some extraordinary testaments of the ingenuity and unbelievable skills of the ancient civil and military engineers. As civilizations developed, people began reshaping their environment to better suit their needs. And of course, with each advancement came a new challenge that had to be solved. Meaning this required more complex and creative thinking and coming up with a solution. This vast field is defined as the creative application of science in order to develop and design works that serve the uses of humankind. The function of the scientist is to know, while that of the engineer is to do. Yes, us engineers need to know how to use this knowledge and deal with practical problems. The profession as we know it today emerged during the 1500s and in the military when there was a need of using mathematics and science, or just common sense, in order to design actual constructions, and thus becoming a true profession in the modern sense of the word. And going through this engineering timeline and taking a peek in the history of everything what's possible and already made, we can't help but wonder who it was that pioneered our profession. Who was the first known engineer? Well, the earliest civil engineer known by name is Imhotep. This guy right here. He was one of the officials of Pharaoh Djoser. And he probably designed and supervised the construction of the Step Pyramid, or the Pyramid of Djoser, located in the Egyptian necropolis of Saqqara. The Step Pyramid was the first of the old, now famous Egyptian pyramids. The Pyramid of Djoser consists of 6 mastabas, which are sloping rectangular prisms, layered one on top of another, in contrast to the smooth face of the more familiar Great Pyramid of Giza. Before Djoser, pharaohs were buried in mastaba tombs, which looked like this. And in addition to kicking off this whole pyramid craze, Imhotep may also have been the first person to use stone columns to support a building. And interestingly enough, despite all this, the pharaonic Egyptians themselves never credited Imhotep as the designer of the Step Pyramid, nor with the invention of stone architecture.